in the north part of the Endeavour segment of Juan de Foucault. And we have Steve here. And so what's a hydrothermal vent?
Well, a hydrothermal vent is a basically a place where hot water comes into the bottom of the seafloor. And because we're very near, we're at a spreading center, so we're making seafloor in this part of the ocean. So the seafloor comes out, spreads out towards the coast and towards the middle of the ocean. And at that area, we're very close to the magma, the hot molten lava that's in the earth. And since water percolates down into the substrate and down towards this hot magma, it gets superheated to really hot temperatures, up to about 375 degrees, so very hot. It doesn't turn into gas there because we have very high pressures, and that keeps in liquid form. So this hot water then rises back up, and where it's rising up, it builds these structures, these chimney-like structures, because the hot water is so hot that it strips a bunch of stuff out of the rocks. So the minerals that are in the rocks, the things that make up the rocks, come into this liquid form, and as it comes out the surface of the seafloor, it hits this very cold 2-degree water, and all these things, these minerals, basically precipitate out to cause this black smoky kind of substance that we'll see in some of the pictures. And basically it also forms the rock again, because it came from rock and now it's building new rock, and that's what these chimney structures are made of. So a lot of it is iron based, but there's a lot of other minerals in there as well.
I saw the black smoke from the cameras. It was amazing. Like, there is something living down in the ocean, I guess.
These things are, there's many different types. The ones that we have are rather large, tall smokers. They're one of the more spectacular ones in this region. But there's also much more diffuse venting, where the water is not 300 to 400 degrees, but lower temperatures. And they also develop, structures around them, but not as spectacular as the ones we see here.
So what is the effect, the impact of these structures, black smoke and hydrothermal vents, on ecology and the inhabiting organisms here?
Well, basically, hot water is a form of energy, so that's one reason we have more life forms here. But we also, since we really disrupt the chemical structure of the water column here, we have bringing a lot of chemistry into it. There are bacteria that lives off this chemistry, and they actually, different types of animals utilize the bacteria, some in their guts and stuff like that, to actually gain energy from them that way, and it basically we build up an ecology around them.
Actually, to give an idea, how big is this area?
Well, the Endeavour Ridge is part of the Juan de Fuca Ridge is a larger piece of a very large piece. It's about 90,000 kilometers long, circling the whole oceans, and we have a small piece called Juan de Fuca Ridge, which is set off by some transform faults. And ours, the section we're looking at is one of six sections or segments of the Juan de Fuca Ridge. It's the northernmost one, and it's about 10 kilometers long and maybe a kilometer wide. And just because the earth crust is now coming out in this area, it's pushing out sideways. We have two little mounds, and we got a valley in between. The valley is about a kilometer wide and 10 kilometers long, and it provides an area where all this life forms can actually sort of stay out of the way of deep ocean currents and actually congregate. So it's about 10 kilometers long, 1 kilometer wide, maybe 200 or 300 kilometers high on the sides.
Yeah, 10 kilometers is a very long, it's a big piece actually. And currently there are 4 moorings installed on each corner of the area. So 2 up in northeast and northwest, and just yesterday southeast and southwest moorings installed. So there's a kind of circulation, and the measurement instruments are installed. So what's the purpose of this study and measurements? What kind of instruments you have in the mooring?
Well, basically the purpose of those moorings is that now we have a valley, and in that valley are these 5 hydrothermal venting areas, and we have a very diverse group of life living here. So we're trying to understand how they stay here and what you know brings them here. We have that notion that we talked about before about the chemosynthesizing bacteria, which is provides the food. But there's also these other secondary kind of processes that help keep the creatures there. And one of them is the fact that we're actually putting in about 1,600 megawatts of energy into the bottom waters here, which is about the size of a medium-sized nuclear power plant. So quite a bit of energy coming in from the seafloor. And that drives this circulation. So it's quite similar to what we see on in coastal areas where you have a valley. If anybody is a windsurfer, they know that you know in maybe the Columbia River Gorge or Nitinat Lake in British Columbia, there's a lot of during the day around noontime the wind picks up because the ground heats up from the sun, and you get this beautiful wind blowing into it. Well, in analogy to that, we have this warm energy coming in as a form of hot water, rising up through the middle of this valley that we have, which is the Endeavour segment, and it drives this flow in on either side, cold water flow. So if you're a not very mobile creature like a larva of some of these creatures that live down there, you're kept in this area because you have this trapping flow that we have, and if you stay below the top of the ridges, then you won't get blown away by the deep ocean currents. So what we're using is these moorings to study the strength of the currents that are coming in and the temperature and salinity of the water, so we know what the water masses are that are coming together here and trapping these little fellows that don't have much swimming power. As you'll see in some of the videos, they sort of move along quite slowly. So any kind of current will override their own swimming power.
So this is the 18th day of the Neptune Canada Wiring the Abyss 2012. And where are we going next tomorrow?
Good question. But I have some information that tells us that we're going to be going to the main Endeavour field, which is where it's the first discovered field of the whole region. It's the biggest field. It has most energy input. And we have a number of instruments there. We have temperature sensors, and we've got a imaging sonar that images the plumes that are coming out of the hydrothermal vents. And we have a couple of vents that we populate with these instruments. There's Hulk, there's Grotto, and it's going to be a good fun day to look at some very interesting pictures.
That's so exciting. So Dr. Steve Mihaly was with us. Thank you for the wonderful interview, Steve.
Well, it's very nice to have this interview. Thank you.
Thanks.